Good morning. Welcome to another day in KidzTown.
We are glad you are here with us today.
I'm Carolyn. And this is Rachel. And we've got a really good morning plan for you. I think we should start with an old favorite. You know what? I don't think Rachel has ever played Pirate Ninja Cowboy before.
Pirate Ninja Cowboy?
Yes. It's our own special version of Rock, Paper, Scissors, except you use your whole body to play.
Okay.
So, pirate, if you look through that little hole, you can see the kids acting out pirate for you.
Oh, yes.
So, pirate, got an eye patch.
Okay.
And
a hook.
A Captain Hook. And arr.
Arr.
Sound like a pirate. Yeah. Ninja, any kind of ninja kick. So, like, arms and legs go flying, that's ninja.
Okay.
Cowboy, sitting on a horse, the lasso.
Woohoo.
Ooh, that's a good cowboy. Okay, so we start back to back.
Okay.
And you can do that as far apart as you need to. We're going to say 1, 2, 3, and then we jump and we turn into our pose.
Okay, but who wins?
Well, pirate beats ninja, ninja beats cowboy, cowboy beats pirate.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Yep.
You ready? I'm ready. Okay. 3, 2, 1. Arr!
No.
Oh, if you tie, you die. That just means you get to play again. And if you're playing at home by yourself, just pick one of us to play with. And then you can see if you win or lose based on ours. Okay? So let's try it again. 1, 2, 3. Oh, I think we think the same. Okay, one more. 3. I'm doing it backwards. 1, 2, 3. That's what I was trying to do. We tied 3 times in a row. Okay, you guys can keep playing that after. I know you'll have fun with that this afternoon.
Before we get to our lesson today, we're going to sing a song together.
All right, let me tell you why I picked this one. We're going to go into a 3-week series on the Holy Spirit. Understanding who he is and what he does is so important to us and to our faith. I picked this song, it's called We Believe, because it's a creed. And a creed is a statement of things that we believe in. And the Holy Spirit is a part of that.
Sing with us.
When all we know is doubt and fear. Spirit, and He's given us new life.
Does anyone know why we might want to teach about the Holy Spirit at this time of year?
It is something to do with what happened after Jesus went back up into heaven, after He was raised from the dead and spent time with His disciples again.
Right. So Jesus ascended into heaven. He went back up into heaven 40 days after He rose from the dead. So He was on earth for 40 days interacting with His disciples. And that day of ascension is later on this week. So that's why we're looking at this stuff right now. But also, 10 days after that is when the gift of the Holy Spirit was given to the disciples, on the 50th day.
Some of you are in grade 3 and are learning geometry. Who knows what a five-sided shape is called?
Well, I can draw one.
It's called a pentagon. Penta means five, and this special time in the church year is called Pentecost because it was 50 days after Easter.
Right, so that's where the name comes from. And that's why now is a perfect time to learn all about the Holy Spirit.
We can't talk about the Holy Spirit without talking about the Trinity, because that will help us figure out who He is and where He fits in. We have one God. Hey, I think geometry will help us with this too.
Ooh, more math.
This is a triangle. Tri means three. This shape is one shape, but it has three sides and three angles.
Very cool. Our God is like this. He's one God, but He has three parts or three persons to Him. We call this the Trinity. Let me write that up there for us. Trinity. That means the unity of God the Father, of Jesus the Son, and the Holy Spirit in one God. Sometimes we say God is three in one.
So God the Father is God, Jesus is the Son of God, and He's God, and the Holy Spirit is God too?
Exactly. And they're all one. It's a little bit confusing. It's a little bit of a mystery. But you know what? I don't mind that there are mysteries about God, because that tells me that God is a lot bigger and a lot stronger and a lot smarter than I am. And He's told us enough about Himself that we can know that He is absolutely trustworthy and that He is true. So if there are things about Him we don't fully understand, that's okay. I'm okay with that.
There are a few things we can look at other than the triangle to give us more of an idea of what the Trinity is like. We brought you two things to show you. Well, this first one has three things.
And here it is.
Whoa. Here we have a jug. It's full of plain water. And here we have a kettle. It's got plain water in it too. And it's boiling. Can you see what's coming out of the kettle?
I see some steam.
Yeah. Steam is what water that is heated turns into. It is water vapor. This is water in a gas form. I also brought this today.
Ooh, what's in there? Ice.
Yeah, it's ice. Ice is what happens to water when you lower the temperature of it. It becomes a solid. So this is frozen water, room temperature water, and heated water. Water as a solid, a liquid, and a gas. They're all water, but different.
That is a very neat way to see something that is three, yet one.
Yep. Water can't be all three at once, though. So it's not a perfect example. But it's pretty cool.
It is. All right, we have another thing in here. I don't want to drop it. I have an egg. This is another example of something that is three in one. You can see one egg here. Mm-hmm. Did you know that an egg has three parts? What happens if I break this egg? My table's not strong enough. There we go. Okay. So you can see that part of it is, I'm trying to separate it so you can see the three parts. but I did break it a little bit. So we've got the shell, which is nice and crumbly. This part is called the white. I know it doesn't really look white right now, but if you cook it, that's the part that turns white. Mm-hmm. And this part is the yolk. Sometimes it'll stay in a nice little ball. I broke it because I cracked it all messy. Wash my fingers. Okay, so all the parts of the egg have different jobs, different purposes. Mm-hmm. If you beat up the white by itself, it'll get really light and fluffy. And they use that in some sort of special desserts. And both the white and the yolk are good for eating. But I wouldn't want to eat this part. But this part's needed to keep the other part safe and intact before you eat them.
Right.
So one part, one thing, three parts. It's another example of Trinity.
So we have one God who is made up of three different parts. Mm-hmm. We hear about Jesus sending the Holy Spirit as a helper to all the believers at Pentecost. Is that when he began, or was he always a part of God?
That is a great question. We can answer it by looking into our Bible, the very beginning. Genesis 1:1-2 says, "In the beginning, God created the heavens and the earth." I think most of you know that one, Genesis 1:1. Verse 2 says, "The earth was without form and without void, and darkness was over the face of the deep. And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters." So if the Spirit of God was there with God at creation, then we can tell that he's always been part of the Trinity.
There are other times in the Old Testament too, where it talks about God putting his Spirit on someone. It hasn't always been for everyone, but when God had special jobs for people, he would give them his Spirit to help them do the tasks that he had for them.
I think that's been a great introduction, and I'm looking forward to the next couple of weeks when we can learn more. But why don't we head over to some breakouts now and see what else we can learn. In our lesson, we mentioned that there were some times in the Old Testament when God would put his Holy Spirit on different people for different reasons. Now, we don't want you just to take our word for it. We want you to look it up and find it for yourselves.
For this activity, you're going to need to find these sheets that are in the notes on our church website, and you'll need your Bible.
Right. So there's four different activities on these. The one I want you to do for sure is the second section of the first page with the references. I want you to look up the references and find out who God gave the Holy Spirit to. And then it tells you here what the job was that he had for them.
Don't forget to send us a picture of your finished work to get an entry into this month's prize draw.
So the Holy Spirit may be invisible to us. We can't see him, but he is a real person. So here's my question. How do we get to know the real people that we see around us?
Well, probably the best way is to talk to them, isn't it? And ask them questions.
That makes sense to me. And you know what? That's what we're going to do now. I want you to get comfy, close your eyes, and we're going to play some music for a little bit. I want you to simply direct your thoughts inside yourself, where you imagine the Holy Spirit lives within you, and invite him to tell you about himself. Say, "I want to get to know you."
This is the last thing we're going to do this morning before we say goodbye, but we'll give you a short chance to do this now. We really encourage you to take a few more minutes after the video to do this for a little longer.
Thank you.
Hey friends, before we go, Rachel has some super exciting news for you.
The registration for our sports and arts camp is now open. We have 3 weeks of camp this summer, and we'd love to have you join us. You can find the dates and all the information on our church website.
Have you ever been to one of our summer camps here at the church? They're a lot of fun.
I can't wait.
All right, we are gonna close off with a prayer and a blessing for you today, so why don't you bow your heads and let me pray for you. Holy Spirit, we worship you and are so thankful that you are real. Thank you for your part in the Trinity, and thank you that you are close to us. We are glad that we've got a few more weeks to learn about you, and we pray that you would give us open hearts to understand this mystery a little bit more.
The Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace.
Have a good week, friends.
Bye. Believe in God the Father.